You Star Wars fans, another FlyGuy.net figure review for you. We reviewed all of the cabinets I've got behind me, and we put up six videos the last couple of weeks, just showing you all the stuff that we had in my collection. As we were going around, I kept asking if anybody wants to see a particular figure getting reviewed, just to let me know. And Andrew's21, if that's your correct YouTube handle, and SithLord229, you guys both wanted to see the Shadow Speeder Bike and the Shadow Scout Trooper. I have to think, yeah, there's so many Shadow variants these days. So we'll give you a usual review of these guys and get into depth of them. Just to quickly just show you the figure overall, this figure is exactly the same as the BTSC Biker Scout from several years ago. So you can actually still get this guy in stores as a Saga Legends figure. So if you're really hunting to try and find these guys down, there's plenty of them around. But we'll give you a look at this guy first. So let us go into detail and show some HD close-up of this guy. We'll give him his close-up. So Shadow Scout Trooper is what he's billed as. As I mentioned, he's identical, exactly identical to the Vintage Collection Biker Scout, which was out, maybe 3-4 years ago. I say that for everything, I actually can't remember. It seems like 3 or 4 years ago. But this guy is really no different whatsoever. He is absolutely spot on, exactly the same. The paint job is not bad. It's this kind of grey and darker grey colour, I guess, that we've got throughout there. But he's a pretty cool figure overall. I have to say, it's probably the worst description that Hasbro give on the box. I don't have it anymore, but I managed to find it online. Basically make it, this guy is, he hunts down shadows, as they call it, which really is just not going to happen. So a bit of a silly premise for this figure overall, but look, it looks cool in black, and that's pretty much what Hasbro did a few years ago. Everything came out in black at one point, to the point, as we discussed in our podcast with DBSW on it, we talked about Shadow AT-AT, which came out in the titanium line. And quite frankly, how you could ever have a Shadow AT-AT the size of them? But there we go. So thankfully, Hasbro have dropped this real madness for Shadow stuff pretty much so far for a while. But there we go. This is the Shadow Scout Trooper. As far as he's concerned overall, he is exactly the same, as I said, of the Vintage Collection Biker Scout. So we have his head rotates. Ball jointed head, completely kind of, you'll see there, it's a ball joint completely underneath. He has articulated shoulders, ball jointed shoulders, and moves at the elbow and also at the forearm. So he's very close to that joint there, but both move. Articulation in the waist, full on ball joint again there, and at the hips. And at the knees. And most importantly, as many will know I love, the guy has articulated boots or ankles. So he's full on. Pretty much everywhere this guy is pretty poseable. A great looking figure, and one I think most people want to add to the collection. I've managed to find this pack out there. It's a beautiful looking pack with this guy riding speeder bike. I can see it online for about 20 to 25 bucks, so that's about 12, 15 pounds for you, Sith Lord, in the UK. Andrea, too, I have no idea where you're based offhand, but you should be able to pick that one up pretty cheaply and easily. So the speeder bike that it comes with is exactly the same as the speeder bike that has came out on numerous occasions from Hasbro. It's absolutely identical. There is no difference whatsoever, apart from Hasbro adding a little bit of paint and some glue, which I'll talk about in a minute. So just to give you a full-on view of the speeder bike, standard bike from that Hasbro have used many, many times before. In actual fact, they've overused this bike. So some silver paint flecks you can see. The camera seems to be having a fit at the moment, but hopefully you'll get to see this. The Imperial Cog symbol, which looks quite nice. Hasbro have also added some three little dots of silver paint there onto the dash and a hint of red, so it's looking pretty good all over. And just at the back, one nice touch is there's a kind of chrome piece, which is the exhaust ports, is definitely kind of titanium or metal, as you'll see from the reflection, which is quite nice. I don't remember seeing that on a previous release, so that's pretty smooth. This blaster moves and rotates. I think that was common on all versions of that before. The older version of this speeder brake used to blast apart. It had a blast apart action, which from memory, you pressed this button here. What Hasbro have done is kept the button, so it's actually, it still depresses and looks like a button, but doesn't actually function fully, and so nothing blasts apart. So all they've done is added some glue in between the joints, and this doesn't blast apart. So pretty standard stuff. The bike will stand on its own. I can't do it here, obviously, but it will stand on its own, so even with a figure in it, it will stand up. It's again, it's one, if you've never picked up a speeder bike before, by all means go out and get this one if you want it. But we have been told that Hasbro are giving us a brand new speeder bike, so one you should be able to get in the coming year and a half. I think we'll get a brand new speeder bike and probably a brand new or a repaint, a retool of the Biker Scout. So there we go. So he looks pretty sweet when you add him onto his the bike. He does bend the legs a little and he's a bit hard to get on there, but you can pose it fairly well. And the there is a kind of brake or a piece that appears just at his knees there. I'll show you with the mirror off, which again does nothing. It's supposed to, or it was in the older version, I think, do something, but this doesn't do anything. So there we go. Not really much functionality on the bike, but if you're looking to pick this guy up, as I said, he is around $20 to $25, I think, so you should be able to pick him up pretty cheaply, and if that's one you want, then go add it to your collection. So I hope that was useful. Let us know what you think, if it was one you wanted for your collection or not, and leave us a comment or something on Facebook, and we'll do some more reviews you guys have requested coming up shortly. Cheers.